National Gallery in London. We are standing in front of a painting by Sir Joshua Reynolds from 1773. It's Lady Cockburn and her three eldest sons, which makes you think it's going to be some portrait of a society lady, very stiff and upright in a dress, and three little boys in very fancy outfits. But that's not really what we have at all.
No, when you first look at it, it's very pink, and you see these very fleshy, chubby children sort of tumbling all around her and holding on to her in the centre. So obviously it's very much focusing on her as mother.
Absolutely. And this is actually a composition borrowed from paintings that have gone before it, which are usually allegory scenes of charity. And charity is usually shown as a mother, because the idea of giving of yourself unto others is usually shown in allegory as a mother with children. So this becomes both an allegory of charity, which is perhaps a comment on Lady Cockburn herself, as well as being a portrait of her and her children.
And this is typical of Joshua Reynolds. He puts people in the position of a historical figure or someone from a mythical past. It's something that he did. He compounded these two genres together, very much his own personal style.
And you get a sense of that here, because you do see this very costly looking gold orangish robe that's draped around her. It looks like fur lined.
Very regal, the way it's laid out.
Certainly.
Isn't it?
And then that mirrors this massive amount of red curtain drapery. And you can see some brocade patterning details in the drapery up at the top, and it's wrapped around a column at the right, which hints at this mythological, classical, ancient Greece and Rome, that sort of past, a little bit of a visual cue.
And we have that little bit of landscape pointing out into the background. Now, this could be contemporary landscape of the 1700s, but also that could be a view off in Rome. We don't know where they're setting them here.
And the other bit of this that connects pretty directly to that idea of mythological allegory is the child who's over on the left side, who has this very tender motherly hand around his back holding him on her lap. He is pulled directly from an image of Cupid that's in a painting that goes by the name of the Rokeby Venus, which is also in the National Gallery's collection. So very directly, that's sort of a Cupid figure connecting to ideas of Venus and back into that mythological genre that Reynolds really liked to do.
And something that is unusual, of course, is that parrot. Why would there be a parrot in this picture?
The parrot was actually Reynolds's pet. Not necessarily an allegorical addition, but it's a pet, and the story goes that this was added to this painting to even out the composition. And honestly, if you imagine it without the parrot, that would seem like a weird hole.
I wonder what the sitters felt about that when they got home, you know, unveiled their portrait. They're like, oh, and there's the painter's put his pet in the corner.
By this point, Joshua Reynolds was quite the so-and-so. He was the first president of the Royal Academy, the school for painting in London. And by this point, he was very well established in his career. So to have a portrait painted by Reynolds would have been very much a status symbol in and of itself.
Yes.
So whether or not they liked the parrot, they might not have said anything.
My favorite part of this painting, if you look at the handling of the paint, is on the baby that's lying across her knee. It's the hair. You really get that wispy feeling of baby's hair. And it contrasts quite nicely with that thick impasto that he's used on the lace on the cuffs.
And I do think that's something also that Reynolds was quite well known for, is this contrast of textures. I mean, look at her cheek, or all of the baby flesh almost, is so smooth, and you don't really see brush strokes, and it feels touchable. And then, as you say, there are other areas where the paint is very thickly applied, and look at the ribbon hanging down from behind her neck.
And the red velvet as well. You can see the brush strokes on that when you get up close. They're definitely very much the presence of the painter is there.
So the painter has both showed you his skill and also blended it quietly into the background.